one of my goals, I think one of all of our goals in making this picture, was to humanize it, humanize what has been a very volatile, controversial issue. We're only talking about human beings.
What were some of the things you learned about the military way of doing things or about military life in general?
Well, Greta is a soldier by the book. Uniform is very important. Having the correct watch is very important. I messed up one day. I had the wrong watch, which it wouldn't have not happened, but not with Greta. She'd always have exactly what regulation was. And that was fascinating to me, how to salute correctly.
I was going to say, did you have any trouble with that? Because that's hard to get down just right.
It is. And there's a certain elegance and kind of casualness about it when you've done it for years and years and years, and to not seem really self-conscious.
What did you hope to bring to the role of Greta Cammermeyer? What did you want to leave people with in your portrayal of her?
I wanted to leave with people, this is a person I can relate to. I understand this story. And maybe because of it, I've changed my outlook a little bit on the whole issue of homosexuality and homosexuals in the military.
How do you feel about the so-called don't ask, don't tell policy that's currently in place?
I think it's, as Greta says, it's stupid. I mean, why should anyone not be able to feel free to be who they are? You know, the great irony, it comes out in the movie, gays have been in the military since the military has existed. They're there, they've served, and they've served extremely well.
In the movie, Judy Davis plays Greta Cammermeyer's girlfriend. Mm-hmm. What was that like, and was it hard for you all to work together in this kind of role?
It was great. Judy, to me, is one of the great actresses of the world. She's, what is wonderful about her, she is a real, unique, original person. And she is incredibly smart and has such clear instincts as an artist.
But just once before the man's dead, I like to hear him say, I'm proud of you. You did a good job, Margaretta. I mean, what does it take? My medals, my marriage, my sons, my rank? I mean, he's tough.
You impress everybody else. You impress me.
In the movie, you kiss your co-star, Judy Davis. There was some pressure, I guess, by conservative groups on NBC to excise that part of the movie, and NBC said no. What did you think of all that, the brouhaha over?
I expected it. But that's also the reason why I did the movie. I think it would have been very dishonest not to have the kiss in the movie. And also, there are moments where I felt a little frightened about what the reaction would be. And then I thought, wait a second, I'm an American. This is America. You're frightened? Another reason why you should do it.
How do you think the gay community, Glenn, will feel about this movie?
I hope for the gay community that it will give them, that they'll be proud of it, and they'll be proud of themselves. And I hope it will allow the whole country to talk about things that they haven't been able to talk about.
You can see Serving in Silence, the Margaretta Cammermeyer story, tonight on NBC at 9 Eastern. We're back in a moment with more on Today right after this.